Hare Krishna. Our thoughts have no power till we give them our thought. We use the word thought in two different senses. I got a thought. That we refer to some stimulus, some idea popping up on our inner screen. Whereas, I have given this a lot of thought. Refers to thought as systematic, sustained, serious reflection on a particular issue. So now, considering these two meanings of the word thought, we can understand that our thoughts, that means the ideas, the desires, the feelings that pop up inside us on our screen, inner screen, on the mind, they actually can't have any power on us till we give them our thought. Suppose we are working on our computer and some distracting pop-up window comes up with a link to a sports video, to a movie or whatever else. That pop-up cannot influence us till we click on it. But once we click on it, a new screen will open up and our attention will get captivated by that. So, understanding that our mind is like a computer screen and many windows may pop up on it. But if we stay focused on what we want to do, then we won't get distracted by other things. We have to learn to see our mind as an observer and evaluate whatever is coming in the mind. The Bhagavad Gita recommends this mood of becoming an inner observer in its 14th chapter, when it says that the various desires and thoughts and emotions that come up within us, they arise from the three modes of material nature. In 14.22 and 23, Krishna says, Prakasham cha pravrittim cha mohameva cha pandava nadveshti sampravrittani nanivrittani kaangshati udasinavadasinam gunaryo navichalyate gunavartantityeva yovatishthati naengate. It says that these, sometimes we feel illuminated, sometimes we feel hyperactive, sometimes we feel lethargic. These are just coming from the three modes, sattva, rajas, tamas. Rather than getting carried away by these, we observe that this is just something popping up on our inner screen. It will stay for some time, it will go away. So when we stay focused on that which is important for us to do, then we will not be distracted by distracting thoughts that pop up within us. And the Bhagavad Gita encourages us to stay focused by connecting with the object who offers us the most attractive focus, that is Krishna. In 14.26 it says, Mamchayo vyabhicharena bhakti yogena sevate sagunan samatityaitan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. That if we become fixed in the practice of bhakti, then the modes may cause many pop-ups to open up within us. But we won't get distracted by them. By our firm practice of devotion, we will transcend them. And as we keep neglecting the pop-ups, slowly they will stop popping up. The distractions will decrease and eventually they will disappear and we will become steadily and joyfully absorbed in Krishna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.